Lucius!
Yo, what's up,
Dad?
Come on.
Welcome back.
Where are you?
For 5 years, the Lyon family gave us one of the best family dramas of our time. In fact, decades from now, I doubt anyone will have forgotten about the famous Cookie Lyon or hip-hop kingpin Lucius Lyon and his sons who fought him for the control of the empire. After 6 seasons, the show finally came to an end in 2019, but sadly they were forced to wrap things up due to the global pandemic. The finale was not what we expected, and it left fans disappointed. Not only were the fans disappointed, some members of the cast were filled with regret about the ending. However, the show has ended, and these amazing actors have moved on with their lives, and many of them have reached new feats in their careers. So today, we're going to show you the cast of Empire and where they are today. But first, give this video a thumbs up, ring the little bell, and turn on post notifications for the first-hand update from this channel. First on our list is Taraji P. Henson. Oh, how big that name is today in Hollywood. Taraji portrayed the role of Cookie Lyon, the matriarch of the Lyon family dynasty in the Empire series. Although Taraji had starred in other movies before this Fox drama, she only gained her global fan base from her role as Cookie Lyon. Her character became so popular that it got a fan club, the Cookie Monsters. According to Taraji, she had a love-hate relationship with Cookie. In her words, "I could not do this forever. Cookie wears me out. I've got to get as far away from Cookie as possible." All that emotion didn't stop her from being grateful for playing the role. Being Cookie changed her career for the better, and she'll now forever be thankful for that. Not to worry. Now that the show is over, we'll still get to see more of Taraji on our screens. After all, she is one of Hollywood's hotcakes. She'll be taking a seat behind the cameras for the first time ever. Taraji will be making her directorial debut with high school comedy, Two-Faced. The movie follows the life of Joy, a black high school senior whose chances to attend college of her dreams are threatened by her wildly popular and charismatic school principal, Gerald, after she confronts him with evidence of his racist past. Joy sets out to expose Gerald for who he truly is. In addition to directing and producing through her TPH Entertainment, she'll also star in the movie as Joy's mother. Taraji recently started hosting a Facebook Watch talk show focused on mental health. The show, called Peace of Mind, shines a spotlight on the challenging mental health issues facing us today. The show is quite different from Taraji's usual scene, but she's no stranger to mental health promotion either. It doesn't stop there. She's set to lend her voice in the new Minions: The Rise of Gru movie, where she'll voice Bellbottom, the main antagonist of the movie. Since the show came to an end, Taraji has done well to keep herself busy and keep the paychecks coming. Up next is Jussie Smollett. Smollett portrayed the role of Jamal Lyon on the show, and he's one of the sons of Lucius Lyon. In recent years, he had a bit of a run-in with the law, and although he was cleared of all charges, this affected his career terribly, and for this reason, he couldn't make it to the final season of the show. It was quite sad, and not just for the viewers, but also for the members of the cast. His fellow cast members wrote to their producers after he'd been asked to leave the show. Their letter contained some emotional words, including, "He's kind, he's compassionate, he is honest, and above all, he is filled with integrity. He's also innocent and no longer subject to legal uncertainty with the criminal charges against him being dropped." Well, unfortunately, that wasn't enough for the show's producers, and they still did not pardon him. That phase of his life is now over, and Jussie is taking the entertainment world very seriously. In fact, he'll be making his directorial debut with a film adaptation of B-Boy Blues, James Earl Hardy's 1994 novel. B-Boy Blues is a staple story within the LGBTQ+ community. It follows the relationship of 27-year-old journalist Mitchell Crawford and 21-year-old bicycle messenger Raheem Rivers, whom he met at a gay bar during the summer of 1993. Smollett isn't limiting his works to just screen and scripts. He's also joined the human rights campaign Equality Rocks, which focuses on music with a message. If you know Smollett, you know he has a couple of albums to his name, so if he chooses to change the world through music, he just might do it right. As of now, Jussie Smollett still lives in Chicago, and despite his legal history, he's done his best to stand strong for his career. Up next is Terrence Howard. He plays the role of the Lyon family kingpin, Lucius Lyon. Howard opted to leave the Empire show because he was going to quit acting. In fact, he did retire from acting in 2019. When asked what he would do after the show ended, he replied, "Oh, I'm done with acting. I'm done with pretending." He also added that he wanted to focus more on bringing the truth to the world. And by the truth, he meant science. According to him, acting was all about pretense. In his words, "I spent 37 years pretending to be people so that people can pretend to watch and enjoy what I'm doing when I've made some discoveries in my own life. Why would I continue when I've got an entire generation to teach a whole new world?" Terrence decided to leave acting to impact more on the future generation in a more realistic way, through science. I guess Howard isn't exactly a man of his words, because barely a year after, he got himself a movie project. He's set to star in the pilot for Delta Blues, a 1-hour drama about the late blues composer and musician William Christopher, the father of blues music. Not only will Howard be starring on the show, but he'll also be making his directorial debut. When asked why he came out of retirement for the show, he explained, "This story is about our history and has to be handled very carefully. I'm committed to telling the truth of the times, even the uncomfortable truth." Well, his coming out of retirement might have been a good cause after all. Next up is Trey Byers. He portrayed the character of Andre Lyon, Lucius Lyon's eldest son. Byers has moved on from Empire and has moved into doing greater things for the culture. He wrote, produced, and starred in the movie The 24th, and since then he's become one of the bosses at Hollywood. The drama was inspired by the racial tension in 1917 Houston, which culminated in a deadly riot. It follows the story of the Army's all-black 24th Infantry Regiment. When asked about the movie, he said, "First of all, it's our history. Like it or not, it's our history. One of the many stories in our history that isn't told, and it's over 100 years old. I think it's always important to know history." He also added that he hopes the movie will spark conversation. According to Byers, he believes that films like The 24th will make people curious about themselves, their history, and their identity. After working on The 24th, he said he's setting his sights on staying in the movie business. In his words, "I love film. I've always loved film. It's always been my passion, and I feel I've been called to tell stories about identity and honor. I'm looking forward to continuing to tell those stories on whatever platform, but I prefer film." Byers is certainly good at promoting stories, and honestly, I'd rather sit through his amazing film works than take a history class. Up next is Gabouri Sidibe, also known as Gabby. Sidibe portrayed the role of Becky. Sidibe made her acting debut in 2009 in the film Precious, based on the novel Push. Her role in the film fetched her an Academy Award and Golden Globe nominations. While acting on Empire, she opened her doors to new opportunities, including a directorial debut after she directed one of the episodes of the show. She also produced her first book titled This Is Just My Face, which is the whirlwind tour of Gabby's life so far. In it, we meet her polygamous father, her gifted mother who fed the family by busking on the subway, and the psychic who told her she would one day be famous like Oprah. She also starred in Come As You Are while acting on Empire, where she played the role of a nurse who drives three disabled men to a brothel catering for special needs. After Empire ended, Gabouri got engaged to her boyfriend Brandon Frankel. While making the announcement, she wrote, "It's weird that people think we're already married, but I guess our hearts and intentions for each other are just that clear to see. My boyfriend proposed, and now I get to hold him forever." She also said in an interview, "I've learned so much about myself through him, and I feel grateful and excited to learn more about the entire world with him by my side. My partner, my best friend, my cat's daddy, my man, my heart, my fiancé." We can certainly say that Gabby found true happiness after the show, and you can't just help but wish the adorable couple the best in their relationship. That's a wrap for today's video. Thanks for watching, everybody. Be sure to subscribe and make sure you stick around for more exciting content from this channel.